10 seconds remaining. Radiant Team Ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant Team Ban.
Slada.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Seconds remaining. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Prepare for battle.
Well, it would have been much more fun if we had a mid-ancient apparition on our hands, but unfortunately, Blitz, we're just going to have a regular old mid-night stalker. Still a fun hero to watch, though.
I mean, Ben had that right reaction there. He was like, no.
No.
There's no way.
Just shut it down. Yeah, just shut it down.
Just shut it down, Ben.
All right, so what do you think? I mean, our analysts felt pretty pessimistic about Monkey Business's chance of dealing with this Broodmother. Do you feel the same way? This Broodmother just is one of those heroes that's going to control, from the drafting perspective, just kind of control the game, and Team Secret will just have multiple openings to move forward?
I think the Slardar is going to do pretty well this game. He's got a lot of really good targets, because there's not a whole lot of armor on the side of Team Secret. Mm-hmm. You're probably going to see a Vlad's pretty early by the Night Stalker to sort of counter this out, but Ember Spirit, notoriously low armor. Brood kind of gets countered by the ability too. Yeah, the laning phase is going to determine most of it, and how well Weehaw does against Miracle mid SF. He's probably one of the better ones out there.
Remains. So as we get into this game, our laning, what are we going to be seeing here? We actually have the Ember Spirit and Ancient Aberration in the bottom lane up against the Slardar. No-Tail will be playing the off-lane Beastmaster. And the two supports, I'm sure, are going to be rotating around a little bit. Flynn's going to be spending his time in middle lane to start with, while Crit heads down to the bottom lane.
Yeah, and they're going to run the same setup where they give Misery the 1v1 matchup. And this time around, he's a Brood, which is an even better position to be in.
Yeah,
they know they're not going to be punished at this
point. I think I've actually seen, I'm not sure if it was No-Tail specifically, that had this matchup against a Broodmother as a Beastmaster. And it went okay, obviously, in like the first 4 minutes. It wasn't too bad when you had counter wards with you. But, okay, Fly's going to actually rotate over now and is bringing in the counter wards with him. This is not a bad idea, and just kind of limiting the Broodmother's farm. But as you said, he should still be able to get so much, especially by like level 5.
Yeah, this Midnight Stalker, it's meant to just put on all-out, flat-out aggression. They've got enough cores on their team already. They have the Ember Spirit, and if you look at Monkey Business's lineup, got a Slardar, I guess, and which is okay, but the main hero here is the Shadow Fiend. So Team Secret, they don't want to make the same mistake that Monkey Business did. They want a space-creating mid, something that can go around, punish as much as they can.
Seems like we could potentially be having Team Secret win 2 out of 3 of their lanes, or maybe even 3 out of 3, depending on how that mid lane goes, and if the Night Stalker is able actually to get a kill once we go into nighttime. But it only seems like Miracle is going to be doing well in CS as time goes on. I can't imagine No-Tail, like, he's doing well right now. He's actually 8-6, a lot of denies, really done well done by him in combination with the Lich, but I can't imagine that's going to continue to stay such a dominant lane for him as time moves forward. And we're seeing this bottom lane where Moon is just being shut out by the supports entirely.
I think the play right now is, yeah, you're going to hit 6 or nighttime on the Night Stalker, but as long as you have one of the supports rotate in for you, it's really hard for Weehaw to commit to a dive or anything. And Shadow Fiend is one of the better heroes against these melee lineups where he can't really get in close because of the opportunity for triple raises. And the solo kill potential is there for Miracle if Weehaw messes up. So he's got to be really careful.
So who do you pull from the support side on Monkey Business into that middle lane once we get into nighttime?
Probably Crit. Crit moves over. He's got some counterplay potential. Again, this is one of the benefits of when you're a Shadow Fiend against a melee hero, is just you have the opportunity to go for pretty much any of the raises that you want to use.
Yeah.
And it's hard for the Night Stalker to get in close, because the way that Miracle should play this is once in a while he raises, keeps Weehaw kind of low in HP. So if Weehaw decides to commit to a gank, if anybody comes in, it's a death for him. You're seeing Miracle, he's just going to abuse this. He's going to sit on the high ground, because he knows that if Weehaw wants to use an ability, he still has to walk through raises. This is right. The correct way to play this matchup.
I kind of feel like Crit needed to pick up his level 2 somewhere before he tried to rotate up to the top lane. Tosk is actually a pretty good ganking hero against Broodmother. You just, once she shows up to throw out some spiderlings or maybe even right click, you just snowball and are able to get the dust and ice shards, and it's a pretty easy gank, I feel, most of the time. But right now, he rotated up to the top lane pre-level 2, is now trying to leech experience without showing himself, which seems to be a rather inefficient way to use this roaming hero, seeing as he's really the one thing for Monkey Business that I felt like they could actually win some lanes with this roaming hero, as Team Secret obviously don't have the same kind of roaming potential.
Alright, so Weehaw is boots behind when it comes to this mid matchup. He only has 10 CS. Miracle's already up to 25. This is something that you expect, though. A lot of people are going to say Weehaw got crushed in this matchup, but it's part of the matchup. Is the Shadow Fiend, if left uncontested, will almost always win his one-on-one matchups. Mm-hmm. The difference, though, is that the Night Stalker can get aggressive a little bit early, which is what you're seeing right now. They know that there's no vision down here, because it's a Slardar. And you absolutely need this kill for Weeha. This is one that you can't afford to get away from you in.
And Moon pumps forward at just the right time. Still, though, he got off the sprint, and that'll allow him to stay ahead of the Ember Spirit, or maybe not. He's actually slowed down so significantly that he was almost able to get there. Looks like they're still going to go for the time, but Moon is going to be able to escape, it looks like. Staying ahead of Weeha has the stun still ready to go.
And Weeha not going to be able to make the commitment for that kill. So, nice dodge there. The power of the sprint showcasing itself.
You've just committed your Night Stalker to this first gank just to kill three position Slaughter, and they weren't even successful. This is pretty significant, because if you notice during this time, the Night Stalker actually has only gotten one CS and a failed gank, so no XP, whereas the Shadow Fiend has just gotten... He's about to pick up 8, and he can even go to the jungle if he wants. This is not a small thing right now.
Yeah, they're trying to take the Tier 1 tower, essentially just providing this overwhelming force by 5 minutes. In order to take it. It looks like they will be successful. Monkey Business aren't going to rotate around and stop it. So there's that. Yes, at the very least, to give Weeha a small bit of gold. More control for Team Secret, but obviously they still have Miracle to contend with. And they're going to have to address him probably sooner rather than later.
You can't just leave him alone in this mid lane, because what he's going to do is just grab a Ring of Aquila and push out by double raising every single time. And this game around, Monkey Business, they've definitely gotten a pretty decent laning start. Like, their Beastmaster's doing fine at top. He's got inflated CS because of the Broodlings.
Yeah.
But this is where Misery should be strong right now, when the supports have to rotate around to kind of help out Moon a little bit more.
How's that top lane going, Broodmother? 19-5, so No-Tail's actually still doing very well for himself. 34-11 only on him.
Yeah, you gotta look at the net worth, though.
Yeah, obviously a lot of those CS is gonna be Spiderlings, right?
Yeah, he should be just
fine
actually right
behind. Wow, I'm a little bit surprised by that. I just figured with the early denies that he was getting in the first, like, 2 minutes.
He gets helped by the tower, too.
Okay.
Alright, so Weeha's gonna rotate back into this mid lane, but you've got a minute and a half left of your night. You're still only level 5. You're a full 2 levels behind the enemy mid. And you notice, pick up the Ring of Aquila, you can just toggle it on when Weeha decides to go for another gank. And as long as they play this defensive style, the Shadow Fiend's gonna get massive.
No-Tail. Dropped a little bit low. This is about the time where the Broodmother is just gonna overwhelm you with Spiderlings if you're not careful. So he's actually going to play black. He does have his level 6, so once he goes back to base, he can actually rotate to one of these other lanes and maybe set up a kill for his team. And instead, give Crit the opportunity to pick up perhaps his level 6.
We saw the Bane rotate for half a second mid to see if he could set up something, but it's so hard to dive when your creep wave just gets double raise. You just have to run away, and he's going to do it again. Getting quite aggressive in this mid lane. Weeha doesn't have any... He's got a regen rune, but even that's kind of inconsequential when you're still 2 full levels behind.
Yeah, all it means he's just gonna try and void for CS at this point. He's actually gonna go for a bit of a push out, but he knows the silence just isn't gonna last long enough, and the physical damage of the Shadow Fiend is actually enough to challenge Weeha quite easily. Even if he is silenced up. Bottom lane, looks like Moon is actually trying to go on a puppy here. He does have another stun coming up, but Misery has made a rotation.
That's a
rather interesting one.
Did this in the last game too, and with the tier 1 tower down, I think it's okay. Yeah. You're going to lose a lot of your web network, but it's not that big of a deal.
Yeah, he'll build it back up over time, and there's this is the kind of the bad thing about running Broodmother in a safe lane is you don't get the same kind of jungle efficiency oftentimes. When you run into the off lane, you have easier access, especially when you're Dire side. You got these 3 different camps on the Radiant side for you to be able to farm up. So I think this does make a lot of sense. This still, yes, like Misery was able to do okay in his lane, but he needs to really start ramping up his farm, and putting him in this lane, especially with the tier 1 tower down, is going to be what allows that to happen.
The Shadow Fiend, though, huge. He's got an Invis rune. He's going to check for stacks, see if he can catch any of the solo supports. King is way mid right now. Puppy's in pretty precarious situation right now. If he decides to back up at all, this should be a free kill for Miracle, but with the creep wave the way it is, I doubt Puppy is gankable right now.
He did see the Night Stalker rotating into the secret shop, so he may feel confident cutting through these trees and trying to go for a pickoff. Meanwhile, in top lane, the smoke is actually going to pop Moon.
bad time to throw down that ward.
I think Puppy's dead. He's walking down right now, but Miracle has a TP. And
yeah, he's going to place this like aggressive ward and back up and probably run into the SF.
Yeah, I think the Tusk actually creates a sandwich for him, because Puppy doesn't have the TP available, but it actually looks like he's going to go the right way and not run into Miracle. And that's a lot of time wasted on that Shadow Fiend.
Oh, Roar in the top lane. They're going to try and lock down the Ember Spirit. Chain stunning him as much as possible, as Remnant isn't going to get him that far away. Oh, but okay, he actually does jump farther up. He's still going to stick around for this fight because he knows Monkey Business has run out of ammo, and he's going to be able to stick around for the experience and might even ensure another kill. But now the turnaround. Uh-oh, Eternal Envy, did you just get way too aggressive? Yes, you did. He's going to be hit by the stun by Moon, and now that trade-off never really worth it unless he can get more. Weeha, well, he's going to be able to pick up the Lich. The Ice Blast comes through, and Moon's going to die as well. So a triple kill for Weeha off of Eternal Envy just playing perhaps a bit too aggressive. Worth it in the end for Team Secret.
I was okay with the first Fire Remnant, but the second one was pushing his luck a little bit too hard.
Yeah.
And Fly was just like, okay, this is a great opportunity. I'm just going to get a ton of XP off of this. And
still, though, I mean, the turnaround there from Monkey Business did expose two of their heroes that ended up dying, so Eternal Envy, he kind of sacrifices himself for the opportunity of Team Secret. Weeha now makes a huge recovery from what was obviously very rocky mid lane.
Yeah, he might actually just die here, though. He doesn't have enough time. Miracle's got a haste rune. As long as he checks the right way, Weeha's still staying. You gotta get out of here, Weeha.
Miracle, alright, ring around the rosy.
Let's see if you can do it, Weeha. He actually gets the chains. Miracle ultimate goes off, though. He actually holds on to it. Now he gets silenced up. He's not gonna be able to do anything. He hastes himself away, though.
Oh, he's in
I hold a Fiend's Grip! Miracle! Why did you go back? He gets caught by Pylai Dai when he just could run to the safety of his team.
This is like the Benny Hill theme song. I don't even know what just happened there. Somehow they walk away with a kill on a hasted SF, which should have been just a free kill for him onto Weeha.
Yeah.
Now Weeha's game is completely set. We were talking about how far behind he was getting, and he was, but the triple kill, the setup on that as well. That was really clowny.
RSF still top of the net worth, but only just barely, considering his very favorable lane and the amount of form that he was getting, and the fact that he's just an SF.
Pylai Dai is going to be picked off. They will get a really good Ice Blast over the top, but there's no one here to take advantage of that.
Alright, so Eternal Envy, he's got a decent amount of farm right now. He's just going to walk up. Still got that Flame Guard available, and he's just going to bounce back in case Moon's got the angle on him. But without Nighttime, it looks like they're sort of reluctant to fight, and I like this decision by Weeha to pick up the Midas too. This will allow him to continue to get aggressive and still buff in GPM relative to the Shadow Fiend.
Oh, man. Team Secret, I can kind of look at that Hand of Midas, especially since he was already looking at it before, and Miracle is going to be gone on here. He's going to be forced to perhaps use the ultimate, actually kind of fakes it out.
Yeah, Misery's just messing with him right now. But you want the Shadow Fiend in this lane right now, because if Misery all-in commits, then Miracle can just pop the ultimate and throw him back. Two Midases on the side of Team Secret right now, and they're not being punished.
That's what I'm going to get into. The fact that they went a Midas on the Night Stalker as well as on Misery's Broodmother. So late game seems very much secured for Team Secret now.
They're doing amazing. Monkey Business is pretty far behind. You've got a Beastmaster that has 4k net worth, but you want to see him a little bit higher, and probably the most concerning fact right now is that your Slardar only has 200 more net worth than the Ancient Apparition does, and your supports are even quite poor. Lich is meant to be pretty poor in general, but you don't want your Tusk and your Lich to be in this situation, whereas Puppy is getting further and further ahead. He even has a Medallion, so Roche is a possibility for their team, and probably more importantly than that too is that if he isn't the one that gets amped, he can use the Medallion of Courage to kind of counteract the Slardar's Amplify damage.
No-Tail still trying to finish up the Necronomicon. They are not pushing down this Tier 1 tower, I feel like, fast enough. Once again, Monkey Business are in an area where they kind of need to be the aggressors, but they're not finding the fights they want. And then if you can find the fights that you want, you kind of have to go for objectives at that point. But You're going to see Team Secret. They're very rapidly going to take control of this Tier 1 middle tower and maybe even get Miracle in the process. They have an Ice Blast over the top. Snowball will be able to save him. Fly gets out the ultimate and does bounce once or twice. Looks like they're going to be able to get Pylite Die here as the Rays will finish him off. The rest of Monkey Business is going to be chased
down.
Misery.
Awkward position.
Yeah, the Amplify damage should ensure. No, it gets over the cliff. He's good. There was no damage to stop that one, and he gets away just in time.
Radiant's middle tower is
Lich for Bane, but meanwhile, got that bottom tier 2 tower down, and all the while Eternal Envy is just farming, and Team Secret have done such a good job about playing around the EE. They make sure that no matter what happens, if Monkey Business want to get into these fights, he's just going to take this time to farm. And I really like this decision. Don't join the fights, make sure that you're securing your farm, and if all goes wrong, secure the late game for your team.
Four man smoke up, Monkey Business. On their way, they're going to run into Eternal Envy, which is exactly what they want. They're going to see him be able to get the roar over the trees, and Eternal Envy is done for. Ta-da! Excellent gank, exact use of the Beastmaster.
But at
you
bottom,
we see the advantages that he brings. But yeah, Slar Dart dies in the meantime.
That's huge right now. You just lost one for one, and your Slar Dart is just so far behind the rest of the field. And your Shadow Fiend, this is a hero that's meant to be quite far ahead, and top, they're going to set up for this.
Yeah, they're actually going to try and fight this one out with Miracle.
We need more
beating
heroes.
Down Pylite Die. He's going to be able to get the kill, but are they actually going to be able to stick around? The Night Stalker still here. The T1 tower does fall and no TPs, but they have stalled up long enough for Misery to get some damage out on this tier 3 tower. The snowball comes through, but obviously Misery is so much faster than that.
I think they expected the ancient apparition to be there. It had to have been a miscommunication because Puppy was still 5 seconds away from having that ultimate.
Yeah.
And maybe if he has that, then you negate the Shadow Fiend's mech, and you can actually just kill him.
Yeah, for sure. Still, though, they only lost Pylite Die. And that seems to be kind of the Team Secret MO lots of times. They can afford to lose their support.
You lose Pylite Die, but you gain more on the map.
And Necronomicon about to be finished up. Boots of Travel on Eternal Envy. What other items do we have going on?
Is this
going
to be the Radiance Broodmother again?
It could be. I mean, the last time I saw Misery playing the Broodmother, he had like 6,300 gold or something, and chose to go for the BKB instead.
6,300 gold? He just stacked it up?
Yeah, he just like stacks on stacks. It was that one really absurd game where Team Secret, was it? I think it was versus MVP.
He's got a lot of money to work with. He doesn't necessarily just have to buy out. He really needs is that Soaring and that Midas, and this is going to put so much pressure on them right now, because what do you really do in this position? You're going to lose that bottom area, and Miracle's going to get caught out. Mech's not going to do anything.
Nope, and he's just going to die. The snowball does buy him some time, and he may be able to survive through the ticks, but he's going to be positioned in a terrible area. Gets off the mech and will be just still chased down by Team Secret. Now the question is, well, Pylite Die actually gets hit by that Death Requiem of Souls, and then now they're going to be able to take out Eternal Envy as well with the Chain Frost bouncing back over to Weeha. They control him up and will be able to finish him off with a snowball double kill for crit. What a big play. That snowball actually served as the serving mechanism to be able to allow them to win a fight. Even if they do lose the SF, they get 3 heroes in exchange.
Biggest thing there was they were really close and grouped up when the SF did the death animation Requiem of Souls, so the Bane almost just instantly got popped. He actually had like 150 health, and he didn't expect that, and then you lost the Flame Guard onto Eternal Envy. Weeha, at that point, it was 1v3, and that was pretty catastrophic, but we've still got Misery farming. He's got 3,100 gold picked up. Let's see what he has. He's got the Radiance recipe, so that is what he's going to go for this time around. And this will kind of turn him into an off carry, and it'll allow him to really do a lot in these team fights just by staying alive.
Yeah, I mean, just the 17% mischance is actually huge when it's applying it to 5 different heroes. Moon will finally get his mobility item. That is kind of okay, maybe not. They're gonna go for a smoke gank first. He was 50 gold away from finishing up that 4-staff.
He needs it too when you're playing against the Ember Spear, but
yeah,
you've got to get a high priority kill and Eternal Envy.
Weeha is not a bad one. They blink forward on crit with a Walrus Punch, and the Amplify damage allows that to do enough damage that quick and easy kill on the Night Stalker sets things up for Monkey Business.
They go for the Roche.
Yeah, I was about to say, take an objective of some kind. I thought maybe a Tier 2 tower, but Roshan is instead a much better target when you have an SF, Necronomicons, as well as, most importantly, Amplify damage from Slardar.
Gonna fire the Ice Blast into here, and it looks like Team Secret still wants to fight this. 20 seconds, you've got Weeha. The nighttime isn't quite there yet, but he does have his ultimate available. And
oh, he's jumping in for it. He's trying to steal it, but no, he's going to be immediately controlled up. Eternal Envy.
You gotta be a little bit careful there, buddy.
I mean, Monkey Business saw the remnant there. They knew what was going to happen.
I think even if he grabs that, he just dies twice.
Yeah.
That was... I don't know if that was necessary. Just because they're not even in that bad of a position whatsoever.
Yeah, Team Secret are still ahead. Yeah, when it comes to net worth and experience.
They're still ahead. They've got a Solar Crest on to Puppy. They've got an absolutely huge spider right now. She's got 9,600 net worth. More than an SF who pretty much was uncontested during the laning phase.
Yeah.
This is just... I think that the idea behind it was okay, but you've got four heroes spam clicking the ground, and you're not quite sure when the Roshan dies.
Wait, huh? He's halfway through his Aghanim Scepter right now, and he's in a decent position to come in from behind until that ward got placed up by our Lich. That'll make things a bit harder for him. They also have a nice aggressive ward farther up in the jungle as well. That scouts out the Night Stalker. Looks like they want to try and gank him up, especially during this darkness, if they could take away that hero. It'd actually be a huge advantage for them to push another objective.
The problem right now for Team Secret is that their lineup isn't meant to be behind. You've got a bunch of heroes that really heavily rely on chasing, but actually getting out isn't very easy. Even at nighttime, the Night Stalker can get controlled up pretty hard by the boars, the roar, anything that the Tusk throws at him. So they've got to be pretty careful throughout this entire area, just because the turnaround potential is so high from Team Business. So if you're Team Secret, if you take a fight at this point, it has to be a guaranteed win. But you don't have as many fighting heroes, nor do you have the control factor. You've got one stun.
You know, normally in a situation like that, I would look at the Ember Spirit and be like, oh, he's fine. But seeing as Eternal Envy's already given a couple of deaths to Monkey Business, I'm a bit concerned.
Yeah, he's 1-4-3. He hasn't had the best game. But luckily for him, Misery is playing that Broodmother. I like that they're doing this now. They're giving Misery the heroes that he really wants to play. I know Clock is really relevant to the meta, but it never really felt like a hero that Misery was comfortable with.
Yeah, they'll catch Eternal Envy. Looks like No Tail finally got him.
I don't even think he has a blink. It's just crit.
Yeah, it's just crit. He just blinks in, walrus punches, that gives enough time for them to get the Primal Roar. Now they get the ultimate out on No Tail. Fiend's Grip and Misery dishing out so much damage they'll be able to get one. We
have
right
a fight you want to take?
This is nasty as they manage to get the Sleep on a Moon. Do they set up for another kill? Doesn't look like it. They're just going to get damage onto this Tier 3 tower. They got two kills, force rotations back, and now they're going to mass TP away.
11-9 is the score, but that was definitely a move that Monkey Business should not have taken. Once you lost No Tail, just get out.
Skitter, skitter, skitter. He's gonna run into crit. Snowball comes out. He throws out another web, but Miracle is there. And yeah. With the Radiance build, this is the one big downside. You're really susceptible to ganks.
I think he was gonna be once he gets amplified, like, no matter what item he got.
I guess he could get a Manta or BKB.
Yeah. BKB is definitely the second item you get.
Yeah.
There's no way he doesn't.
Is Fly gonna die here?
No.
I hope not. He just bought back. His item progression just died.
The funny thing is, he might have actually kind of saved himself because he ice armored himself, but then he also frost blasted the siege creep, which killed a whole bunch of spiderlings that were around him.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. So Puppy, just casually farming. I don't even know how people have fun playing Ancient Apparition in pro games. You just be so cautiously, and you're an ulti machine. Just make sure you don't die.
Yeah. The thing is, with this Ancient Apparition build, it's kind of weird and interesting at the same time, is that he actually has to be close to fights because he has to be there for the Solar Crest. So he's got to be decently close.
I think when it comes to the 5-man pushes, this build is going to be effective at the top.
This could be a great setup for the Bane, but never mind. Necronomicon comes out, Bane immediately gets targeted down. If only he could have maybe gotten the Sleep and Fiend's Grip on these two heroes, that double control could have offered an opportunity. But as it is, the opportunity swings in Monkey Business's favor instead.
They've got a gem and a Necro 3, so Misery's going to have a really rough life. He picks up the Boots of Travel, which I think is the right idea, because you want to be able to finally really help out your team in case these 5-man engagements go poorly. This is a hero that you want. Unfortunately for him, though, he's still really not very tanky. Like, none of their team really is. You've got a 1600 HP Night Stalker, but that's a hero that, if you get amplified, you're going to get down regardless. I'd really like to start seeing the BKBs filter in for Team Secret.
They desperately need them at this point, but
This is really the point where Monkey Business can actually control the game with enough vigor that they can actually prevent these BKBs from coming in, and they could just take down objective after objective.
Yeah, despite the two Midases, they're actually ahead in net worth, and Team Secret, you really don't want that, because you've got a lot of different heroes that rely on not being able to be in the fights early, like Misery, like the Ember Spirit, so they're going to get this bottom top tower, but they're probably going to lose their bottom tier 3.
Yeah, that'll go down to Creeps. Misery's not actually showing himself because he doesn't want to get hit by the Amplify damage.
And careful, no tail.
Miracle. Yeah, Miracle's done. He gets Fiend's Grifted up. So, I'm not sure how they actually left that scenario where the Shadow Fiend was going to get caught. Maybe just Hasty TP's back due to their tier 3 falling in that bottom lane. Maybe just made some sort of mispositioning error.
I think that is what happened. Get a little bit uncoordinated when you see a Brood just pushing down a lane for free.
Yeah.
And typically in these scenarios, you want to be able to go together as a group. Move. If you move as five, there's no way that Team Secret engaged that. But as soon as they saw two TPs at bottom and not all five,
right,
you're thinking to yourself, okay, they've left some stragglers behind. Let's just get really aggressive. Because no matter what, we'll have the numbers game. If need be, if it's like three heroes are left behind, the Misery can TP in, and you take a 5v3. In a game, in pro games, most of the time, it's just a numbers game. If you have any sort of numbers advantage, you'll take it.
Time to give the gem over to the Slardar, because you're going to watch, the snowball's going to come out, but Moon is on his way with the sprint. He's got both the Blink Dagger and the Force Staff. Grit is still in trouble, though. Those Spiderlings are following him down. They will be able to stop him, though. They'll actually nuke and make sure that Grit survives. The Ice Blast is not going to be on point this time around.
So all Misery has to do is stay alive. Yeah. This phase.
If he could just stay ahead of this Slardar, which, you know, they've given the gem over to him because he's got these double mobility items, and he just gets the Amplify damage onto Misery. Chase him down pretty easily. Highlight die.
They just need more Varmin on Eternal Envy right now, because if you've already got a Brood, you can't have two dead heroes, like heroes that don't really provide anything for you in these fights. You need the ability to actually add all up, 4v5, but Eternal Envy just doesn't quite have the farm to be able to do that. So they're relying on these mini picks and hoping that Misery does enough economic damage at bottom lane.
Nice little horde of Spiderlings ready to go to clean up the next wave as it spawns. So Monkey Business, even if they are chasing away the Broodmother, they're not going to be able to stop this push.
This game's really even right now. The Shadow Fiend still has a ton of net worth. Misery's the top net worth on Team Secret, but one of his items is a Midas.
Oh, they see this. Looks like they're going to go for Crit. He actually does just barely land that Ice Blast, and Nightstalker gives them the walk away. They know Crit's done for.
Maybe the play there.
Top lane, Eternal Envy's going to go down. Another Blink initiation. Moon finds the stun, and Beastmaster has a Blink Dagger as well. So now Eternal Envy is just going to be constantly hunted by these three different heroes with near instant stun. There's a bit of animation on both Slardar and Beastmaster, but Tusk is pretty fast with that Walrus Punch. Probably the least of animations.
That's part of the issue. When you're playing against a Slardar with a hero like Ember, the 15 armor reduction when you've only got 7 base to begin with, you get ripped apart really quickly. It just takes probably Slardar and one hero. They could probably do it with Crit. Yep. If they need to. Just the Walrus Punch on top of that. But you've still got a lot of different ways into this game if you're Team Secret. It's not even like they're far behind. It's just that taking fights at this point isn't really feasible. Because you got two heroes that can't really get into the thick of things. Whereas if you look at Monkey's lineup, they're behind in net worth, but they've got heroes that can get into the thick of things. So you got a Slardar that's going to be pretty hard to take down, because they don't have any immediate burst damage heroes.
Yeah. And a Broodmother, like, the Ember Spirit is their best late game hero. A Broodmother is going to fall off eventually. Nightstalker definitely falls off when it comes to, like, his damage that he provides in teamfights. Yes, Vision is amazing, but if your Ember Spirit just doesn't continue to put out as much as you need him to, then Monkey Fist is just going to roll you over, even if you can't see them coming.
I think this is a decent fight for them to take. They've got the positioning. Misery's got the network of webs right now. Monkey Business, I don't think they really want to risk this. Because all you're getting is a tier 1 at bottom. There's no real point in going for it. Eternal Envy almost has that Battle Fury, but it's still pretty late. It's 30 minutes into the game when he's going to grab it. And the amount of impact that you want to see this hero have isn't quite there.
Puppy's pretty farmed, though. They'll have a really significant grade coming in quite soon. He's 3/4 of the way there to the axe.
Yeah, Puffy right now is... He's definitely holding it together. He's only...
They're gonna find Misery. I think they will.
Misery should...
They should just follow the webs.
All the way through.
Just turn off the radius.
Maybe it's the Force Staff. They... Not seeing him just yet.
With this hawk, he's definitely gonna get spotted.
Oh yeah, now they see him. Misery, he's stuck in the trees, they're gonna snowball him, finally catch him out. They took a lot of time for Mugnusness to find him, but seeing as he's quite heavily the top net worth for Team Secret, it was worth the investment.
988 gold won, 509 loss. Yeah, I'd say that was worth it.
Yeah.
This just isn't a very defensive hero right now. If he gets caught by any ability, he pretty much dies. Trying to set up the bottom of Pylite Die and Weehaw. But this is not really a fight you want to take. There's no reason. I think Weehaw is pretty close to that BKB, which I think is the item that he should grab. You don't want to slow down the momentum of this Night Stalker if you can help it in these team fights.
And for the first time pretty much all game, Monkey Business are in a good enough position that they can take down these outer towers that were still left in the bottom lane.
Oh, this is so smart by them. You're noticing that they're going to show two heroes at bottom. They should start backing out now. And Eternal Envy, he thinks that there's five heroes behind them at the top.
That's exactly where they jump in. Eternal Envy is going to be perfectly chain stunned down. A beautiful plan from Monkey Business that exposes Eternal Envy once again.
That was so intelligent by them. They even showed No-Tail. That was the perfect hero to show. Because then Eternal Envy thinks, even if it's a trap, what do they really have?
Right.
Slaughter is probably a bottom
lane. Oh, and now they're going to get the pick off on bottom lane too. They get up the gem as well on top of everything else.
They're just getting outmaneuvered right now pretty hard. Yeah. This is really intelligent play by Team Monkey Business. Like, to maneuver around the map like that is so smart. You show the three heroes off the map, show the two heroes that are most likely to be the ones to take down the Eternal Envy, and then they set up another trap at that bottom lane when Team Secret thought they had actually left. So Team Secret looks for the fight, but it's only the Night Stalker. Then he runs into two, instantly dies. And now this is going to be a Roshan, a tier 1 tower, and they got both of the cores from Team Secret.
They're going to keep this pickoff potential rolling as they're going to find Puppy as well without that Ice Blast. They could probably push uphill in the next 50 seconds as Roshan's going to go down to Miracle quite easily.
That was Puppy's first death of the game too.
Yeah. There it is, Aegis. They're going to push forward. If they actually find even more heroes, Moon is going to start running down. Misery can't quite get off that amplified damage. And now Misery just puts himself in the trees. They get the stun. He breaks down those trees, but he's going to TP out. No tail. Oh, no. They see him just at the last half second, but can't stop him in time.
And TP bottom. They'll start the split push, and this is something they have to do. The Aegis completed on to Miracle. It's going to be really hard for them to hold it. You've got to pop this Aegis, but he's just going to get Urn charged up. And Misery's just going to try to trade out. He doesn't have TP for another 20 seconds, so he's got to move quickly.
Oh, they actually jump forward. They're going to go for Wii. They pop double ultimates here just to make sure he dies. And with that AoE of the SF, there's no way Team Secret can actually push forward until the buyback. Now the Ice Blast forward, but the turnaround potential, they're going to go straight for Eternal Envy. Lock him down once again. Crit. He has just been cleaning up Eternal Envy time and time again. And they don't even lose the Aegis off of that. Down for 50 seconds, and Team Secret going to probably have to give up a full lane of rags here. Crit's backing himself up, and Monkey Business are slow playing it, but he can't slow play it for too long because Misery will take that melee racks if they're not careful. Jump forward, Slaughter's going to try and catch him out, does get the amplified damage, misses the stun though. Misery will kind of stay one step ahead unless he gets
go
the
for
bash.
The bash caught!
Oh, first hit bash for Moon! Now Misery, he has to get himself away with the webs, but he's been stunned up. Once again, maybe he can turn and fight though. Moon's actually slowly but surely taken down, but the Chain Frost comes in. They also have extra support. The SF is coming in from the side. Misery's desperately trying to get away, but they have full vision of him, and there's just no chance for a Broodmother.
So godlike. You knew it was gonna happen.
Yeah.
But Moon starts the backup, he sees the TP. I think Misery, if he just started running away, Moon would have given up on it.
Uh-huh.
But goes to the TP, wants to make the safe play. He played the odds. I think that was an okay play to make.
Mm-hmm.
He played the odds. It's a 25% chance. That's just really unlucky. 1 in 4 manages to catch him out. And Misery was one of the ways that they were going to keep in this game.
Yeah.
And with him dead, that is a really significant pickoff.
Especially since they're going to halt all momentum in that bottom lane and push it out. And probably that's going to be the next... if you have perfect control and
no, they're
you
gonna
have
just
any choice...
For...
Right, you push down the bottom lane because that's a lane that's exposed on your side.
Oh, yeah, for sure. and more importantly is you want to make sure that Team Secret, they've got to start another slow push on the side of a map where you've already got a tier 2 tower. And with this, No-Tail's just going to come in. Well, Envy is going to be able to survive, but we just really haven't seen the impact of this Ember Spirit.
They've now got the Butterfly, and obviously still rocking the Aegis for the SF.
20k net worth, unbelievable. Just nobody on Team Secret that can really fight into that. And Weehaw at one point had 4k gold, but buyback for that fight and two pretty disastrous pickoffs resets him.
What a gigantic swing this has been over the last 8 minutes or so, where Monkey Business like really got rolling. They had all these smart maneuvers around the map, and it's about a 10,000 gold swing. Now they've got a Solar Crest of their own between the Butterfly and that Solar Crest. No MKBs, obviously, on the side of Team Secret. They could just put the SF on the front lines, especially if he has a double damage. So this is going to be the melee ranks going down. They're probably just going to go bottom immediately afterwards and force Team Secret.
Crit has a full hex. What a beast this guy is. I can't even... 5-1 and 9, every time he plays Tusk, he goes insane, and this game is no different.
They're just slowly but surely trying to chip away at Miracle to try and burn that Aegis before the real fight occurs, and it looks like they're not quite going to get it. He gets the heal off. The Ice Blast just didn't last long enough.
The Night Stalker is going to go for the split push at top, but top tier 2 tower is so healthy. I think this is one of the better opportunities that Monkey Business is going to have. But
because there's no counter pressure, right? You can afford to really play it slow, and there's no like, oh, Broodmother's going to take our tier 3 if we don't push in the next 30 seconds.
Yeah, but No-Tail's going to TP top. I think they're afraid because the Aegis timer isn't as long as they want it to be, and they've got so much control in this game right now. Their item progressions are pretty sick. The fact that your support Tusk has a fully completed hex, that's going to play a really big difference in these fights.
Another gem picked up for that Night Stalker, but I'm not sure how much of a difference it's going to make. If you're trapped inside your base, I suppose you could see the hawks that are going to set up on the side of the base and give some vision, but not going to offer a whole lot for yourself anyway. He sees the ward, but Moon, if he had kept running forward, he actually could have caught Night Stalker with a blink.
Alright, so 42, 43 minutes in, that's when Monkey Business is going to start to get aggressive again. They're going to look for these individual pickoffs, but there's no reason not to wait for the Roshan at this point. You let it happen. Chill if you can help it.
Alright, we finally have something for Misery. I can see why he went for the Boots of Travel, but that mid-lane exposed him so much. Weehaw is going to be caught. Moon, he'll commit the BKB in order to get this kill. Having a little tough time of it, but they finally do take away that gem.
They had to commit the Chain Frost, but it's probably not a big deal, and Eternal Envy's just trying to buy time.
Yeah, he's just trying to get a little bit extra damage out from the Remnant. On the right-hand side, Pylai Dai is going to be taken out once again. Miracle picks up kill.
No buyback on the Night Stalker.
And now they're going to jump on a Puppy without the Ice Blast, Team Secret. They don't have any buybacks. This is pretty much over.
I don't think they can really fight here. They're even going to spot Eternal Envy out. He's just going to have to get out. He doesn't have any Remnants left over, but...
Oh, the damage on that! Jesus, with the amplified damage, just No-Tail. Like, his right clicks aren't that tremendous, but between him and the Necronomicon, he was just tearing Eternal Envy a new one.
That's the GG ult.
Celebratory ultimate for Miracle.
That's the get out of my game ultimate.
Yeah. Team Secret, they're not calling it just yet, but Monkey Business. They can very easily take these tier 4s, and there it is. And the series is all tied up now. Monkey Business. They had a rough start to game number one in this series, and even game two was looking a little risky for them, but they really started to take control of the game with several pickoffs in a row on Eternal Envy. They just took such a gigantic net worth advantage with those.
They're one of the best teams when it comes to controlling a lead, but that's what they didn't have in the last game, is they were never really able to get their footing right. This game on, their superior map movement and the presence on the map, I mean, that bottom gank, and when they set it up for top, they show two heroes bottom,
yeah.
They go for three at top. I know it's not like the most exciting play, but as somebody who really likes watching high-level Dota, that just got me.
All right, so fantastic plays by Monkey Business. We're going to jump over now to our analysts, as they're going to talk about this game too, and who's going to be winning that game number 3 to move on in the playoffs.